Hello, Kaiko here, and welcome to the chaos. Let's go.
What are we going to do today? Well, you might be wondering, why are we back in the chasm? I thought we finished the chasm. You would be correct, we have finished the chasm. Except, there is one more world quest. I think this is part three of whatever the one we were doing with Zhiqiong with the beacons, and then we had to go rescue her. I think this is the final part. So we're going to do this first, and then we're going to be going to do... What is this? We're probably going to be doing this, but second, we will be doing the Yelan story quest, because we've unlocked it now, and I thought, you know what, might as well. What is this? Oh, I haven't done her yet. I'll do her later. And then we have this, which I think is this thing in this events. This thing. Photos. I think that's what we're going to do. Have we done all of these? We did that. We did that. And I think we've done all of these. Yeah, so the only thing left is, so part one of today, helping Jinwoo and Zhiqiong. Part two, Yelan story quest. Hopefully there'll be some spy shenanigans to make the title worth it. And then part three, whatever the camera thing is, the photo taking. And then part four, don't know, maybe we'll go into Enkonomiya and see what's down there. And also, I still want to get Fremenae. So, I don't have enough for 10 though, but like, Fremenae, how many, what's 3 times 160, 480, not quite enough. I might just do a couple of them, I don't know, why don't we do 3, I just really want Fremenae, okay, because I'm just little penguin dude. But it's unlikely to be good. I can only do single ones because I just don't have the money for this. But I changed my mind. We're gonna do 5. Just because I really want the little penguin, okay? We're gonna see if we can get him. And then if we can't, well, there's a couple more days. See if I earn enough primer gems to do a couple more of these. But I don't think my luck's that good, unfortunately. Okay, so far we've just got classic 3 stars. So let's see. This was number 5. Nope, that's blue. I'm just gonna do it anyway. There's only enough for one more anyway. So. Oh, okay. Noelle. Ah, dear. Noelle, you're great. But I just wanted Fremenae. Okay, never mind. Noelle's now like up to a year though, so that's gotta be good. Except I just don't use her, but I'm sure it's gonna be fine. Maybe I'll get lucky. Oh no, I think my mail for today might have been I think I'm at like 140 now, so if I can earn 20 more we can have one more go. But oh dear. Anyway, how have you managed to send so many messages in like 2 minutes? What are you on about? Ads. What are you on about? When Yaya story quest? I don't know. I really hope they do like a. Well, she wouldn't get a story quest because Yao Yao is a 4-star. But if they ever have a Yao Yao hangout event, I will do it on stream instead of off stream because Yao Yao. Because usually I do the hangouts off stream because I'm like, it's too much dialogue. I say, knowing I read all the dialogue and all the world quests which have a lot of dialogue, but still, but if there was a Yao Yao one, I couldn't deprive you guys of the Yao Yao one, so we would have to do it. But yeah, I hope it, I hope it does, but I don't know. 6, Kuki has a story quest. Shinobu? I don't think so, she has a hangout event, I think. Yeah, she has one of these. Hangouts. If Yao Yao should have one of these. If Yao Yao has one of these, I would do it in a heartbeat. But unfortunately, she does not currently. but yeah, anyway. C6, no, not quite. I think I have C5. As far as I'm concerned, all of Keiko's streams are Yao Yao hangouts. You're not incorrect. Anyway, let's talk to Jinwoo. Jinwoo, hello. Hey there, Jinwoo. Are you doing fine? Yikes, you scared me. Sorry, anyway, if you're looking for Zhiqiong, she left. Where'd she go? How was she doing when she left? Khadiv did a checkup and he said that he didn't look too promising. I had a talk with her, but she insisted on leaving. I doubt I could have cajoled or browbeat her or even beat her into staying. I just hope she knows what she's doing. I really do hope so. Right, I have to tell Mooning and get him to organize a search party for that kid. We'll go to Mooning, relax a little. That's Zhiqiong, she's gone again. Let's head back to the surface and look for Mooning quickly. That's not good. No, I'm concerned. It kind of sounds like Zhiqiong decided she was just gonna run away and live out the rest of her life. And no, that's not how this works. Anyway, let's go look for Mooning and see if he knows where she's gone. Oh. Okay. Let's see. Amber, Kaya, and Lisa have story quests. Oh! Yeah, I guess they do! I think Kaya also has a hangout? Maybe? But I guess they were kind of the first character, so it kind of makes sense for them to have a story quest. Does he have a hangout? Yeah, Kaya also has a hangout. Look at him! He's got two! what was I doing? Oh, yes, this. Wait, how many Primer Gems is it gonna give me? 20! Ooh! It's just enough for one more, one more pull. Okay, one more wish. Oh, hello, Eryx. Good to see you. Welcome to the stream. We are finishing the final section of the whatever's going on in the chasm, the Zhiqiong wild quest, and then we're gonna be going to do Yelan's story quest. Why so many Genshin characters I've worked as just slash reckless? I don't know. It just be like that over there. It just is. Always. Very, very upsetting. Zhiqiong's not with you. Word's gone down. Comes out from the ministry. On account of the invaluable help her maps have brought to the Huaishan Hall, the Ministry of Civil Affairs has decided to make an exception for her and, let me see, invite her to be formally accepted as a consultant and guide. Congratulations to her in order. It seems that all that running around wasn't for naught. She left. Left? What do you mean? Do you mean she left first? But the Malouf didn't tell me of anyone leaving the chasm. Zhiqiong left the team. Wait, hang on a moment, you mean she left the exploration team? As in Zhiqiong left the team? Yes, which part of that didn't you get? I get it, I'll put a search and rescue party together immediately. If she's still in the chasm, we should be able to find her. She might just be doing something harebrained again, or perhaps she left for another reason, but regardless, we must find her. In her current condition, working away from the team is simply far too reckless. About Zhiqiong. She's a restless one, but whatever the case, we are still friends. I might not be the friendliest person around, but I don't simply forget friendships just like that. She's always talking about some big adventurous dream or something, and she's actually been injured quite seriously several times before. Nearly bit it on at least one occasion too, and I hear I thought she'd settled down for a bit. I'd hope that she'd have forgotten those unrealistic dreams of hers already. I'd hope she'd have forgotten... Roald, Stanley, it's not all wine and roses with them, you know? But I never expected... To be honest, I was starting to wonder if asking you to come to the chasm was the right decision. If we hadn't, she might not have had a fire lit under her again. Her efforts did produce some results in the end. It is her choice, you know? Choice, you say? Excuse is just going there to die, didn't you realize that? Sorry I spoke too harshly there. Still, couldn't you just exercise a little more patience in the face of things that we mortals cannot change? In 20 or 30 years, maybe in 10, we might have safer underground equipment. Then she wouldn't have to worry about having to go on expeditions to make underground maps. She's not willing to wait for any of those things. Not at all. No, she just has to finish an entire life's work while she's still so young. It's folly, I say, and as a friend, I can't just leave her be. As such, please leave the search for her to me. More accurately, just leave it to the Middle East search party. I'll be there if you need me. Hi, Mantu. We can't just leave our junior adventurer behind. We'll look out while we're on the road as well. Who knows, maybe we'll bump into her somehow. Oh, that's done! Wait, she's not coming back? Have we read this already? I don't know. I'll read it again. Resumption of work for the miners, provisions for their food, and changing of relief guards, contract signings, equipment overhauls, and weekly reports. So you need help with anything? I mean, I'm a bit busy right now, but... No, I think this is the same thing! Where is she? Are we... That's just it? What? Wait, did she go back when we weren't looking? Because that feels very underwhelming if that's the end. I think I saw something once about there being a something over here. So I might go check if she's hiding over there, but still, I thought at least we'd go and find her. But no, everyone's just like, yeah, she'll be fine. What do you mean she's not gonna be fine? Do you have anything to say? No. No, you don't. Okay. Well, I know that there was supposed to be something over here. As in, I'm pretty sure there's supposed to be some achievement if you go over here. I don't know. Oh, there's a viewpoint though. That wasn't there before. Do I know exactly where this is? No, but I'm pretty sure she's hiding over here somewhere. We're gonna have to look for her. Because this is a bit of a rubbish ending. We get this viewpoint. Now, where could Zhiqiong be? I think she's somewhere in this region. Where would she go? If you were Zhiqiong, and you were hiding away from the world by coming into this scary place, where would you go? Maybe I should have gone up high. I don't know. I wonder if I can see better up high, but also maybe I wouldn't. Where is she? You would go to the talking mushroom place. We can have a look. Oh, there's something up there. What's that glowing yellow thing? You wouldn't be lonely. Oh, true. I like the talking mushroom place. We can go back there for a second to just appreciate, bask in the mushroom's glow. But first of all, oh, this might be one of the beacons. I forgot we placed these here. Well, that's a bit disappointing. I thought it was like Zhiqiong, but it's just not. Where is she? Maybe she's not here. I'm pretty sure you're supposed to be able to find her, but maybe it's one of those the next day kind of thing. This place is kind of pretty, but kind of creepy. Maybe she's next to this teleport waypoint. She down here? No, that's an abyss mage. I'm just gonna leave them. They can stay over there. I don't want to deal with them. Okay, I guess maybe she's not here. You know, I'm gonna check the mushroom place anyway, just on the odd chance. I like the mushroom place. We can have a look. Actually, let me go the other way. But we can go in from this end. I think it'll be quicker. It's closer to the mushroom. Let me see. You have more prime gems than me. Fair enough. See, I did have a whole load until I really wanted to get Fremenet. And now here we are. This is not quicker. Why did I think this would be quicker? Oh, that's true, there is food here with the mushroom guy, because the mushroom, I mean, you know, worst case scenario, the mushroom is made of mushrooms. You could probably eat it. Should you eat it? Maybe not, but you could. I'll circle around it once, but I don't think she's here. But also, it's not like I'm very good at finding things, so I could have been staring right at her at any point and just straight up missed her. It makes a soft, like, I want to say magic sound. Like, it's a little, there's a noise, like a humming. Oh. I'm still alive? Okay. Huh. I like this mushroom. There we go. Wait, is Yao Yao drowning? Oh gosh. Yao Yao, why are you so short? Okay, there we go. We can appreciate the view. Oh well, I guess we can't find her. She's an abyss mage. I guess. Just like how a random NPC and giant for two agents. Oh, that's true. That could do it. You can eat the star. Yes, you can eat the star shrooms. That is true. I never do though. You know what? Let's. Yeah. You can eat a mushroom. Go on, have one. Go on, yeah. It did like nothing. She has too much health that the little star shroom does nothing. The mushroom is our friend. It is our friend. Hey, mushroom. Do you know where Zhiqiong went? Mushroom. What's his name? Zavdavan? Zamaran, do you know where Zhiqiong went? I don't think he knows where Zhiqiong went. I don't think she knows. He knows. Never mind. In which case, it is now time to actually do the Yelan story quest. Because I guess she's just not here. In which case, let's go and find this. Ooh. Guess we gotta go to Liyue. Which makes sense. Yelan is from Liyue. You can eat infinite at once? Oh. Does Paimon know this? I don't know. Does she? I think not. But I don't know if Paimon would want a mushroom. She seems to enjoy like a good meal. But I don't think a mushroom would satisfy her. She'd probably want like a burger or something. Oh well. Kaiko, Paimon, it's been a long time. Oh, hey! Huaixin, long time no see. Fancy meeting you here, how's work these days? Thanks to the help of people like you and colleagues like Gunyu, better all the time. But I've been feeling distracted at work lately, I just feel constantly agitated. Has something happened? There's a long story of my father, he's thinking of stepping down from the Tianshu position due to health issues. Huh, what's wrong with Uncle Tian? Nothing. Specifically, he's not unwell, he says he's just increasingly low on energy these days. He's always said old age comes for us all in the end. Still, I just can't help but feel a little emotional watching it happen to him. Anyway, my father's currently on the second floor of Yansheng Tea House. Why don't you come pay him a visit with me? He seems very fond of you too. I'm sure chatting with you will make him very happy. Sure, let's go. Okay. Let's go over there. How are we gonna get up there? I don't know. As in, I don't actually know if there is there. Oh, there is a staircase. For some reason, I was imagining having to get Kazaha just to climb up here. Uncle Tian, we're here to chat with you. Oh, huh, what a lovely surprise. Welcome, Huaixin. Why don't you go downstairs and get the shopkeeper to make us a fresh pot of tea? I heard you've been traveling all around the place recently. I would very much like to hear your adventure stories. We're more concerned about your health, Uncle Tian. Is everything okay? Huaixin told you, didn't she? Don't worry, I'm quite alright. It's just the years gradually catching up with me. As I grow older, I'm starting to find that with many things, that the mind is willing, the flesh is weak. Especially recently, I've noticed a rather drastic drop in my energy levels. I'm still very much in good standing as a Tianshu today. Nevertheless, I wish to pass on the position before my mental acuity begins to decline beyond redemption. How difficult is it to transfer the Tianshu position? Oh, well, you see, the Tianshu is a rather unique position among the Liyue Qixing. Historically speaking, the Tianshu rarely appears in public. We stay behind the scenes, planning and giving advice. The public selection process would not be suitable. We also want to keep any prospective Tianshu candidates free from influence by outside forces. We tend to be as discreet as possible in their assessment and appointment. For these reasons, the incumbent Tianshu typically recommends their candidate of choice, and this is then approved by the other Qixing members. In other words, you pick someone and then Lady Kaqing, Lady Ningguang, and the other Qixing appoint them. Correct. Unfortunately, due to my health, I won't be able to assess every candidate myself. Not to despair, however, because I found someone exceptionally capable to act on my behalf as assessment officer. In fact, I believe you recently became acquainted with her yourself. Oh, who is it? I'm heartbroken. I thought it might take a little longer than this to forget all about me. Ooh, I see. Are we going candidate assessing? It's Yelan. A jackpot, Uncle Tian here asked me to assess three candidates for him.
Fancy joining me, Kaiko? You'll be among the first to get to know the next Tianshu. Might be a good opportunity for you. What do you think, Kaiko?
It is a good opportunity. Someone thinks so too. It can't be a bad thing to be on good terms with the new Zhiqiong, right?
Alright then. Though I gotta say, Uncle Tian, you say you're into behind the scenes planning. My work's of the covert variety too. Don't you think I might make a good Tianshu?
Huh? Yelan, you want to be the next Tianshu?
I'm not opposed to the idea, but I suspect Ningguang wouldn't let you go very easily after how long you've been working together. So how about this? If your investigation reveals none of the other candidates are qualified for the position, I'll recommend you for the job.
Deal. Well, you guys take your time. Everything's all set for the measurements to go, for the assessments to go ahead.
Meet me on the first floor when you're ready. Until then, have a pleasant conversation. Oh, and no need to pay for your tea. As the new owner of this fine establishment, this round's on the house. After telling Uncle Tian about your recent adventures, you return to the entrance of the tea house. You're all set?
Uncle Tian seems really worn down. It's like all his energy's gone.
Yeah, it may sound harsh, but Uncle Tian is past his prime. He's not cut out for this anymore. He's recommended three candidates. Their names are Qian Wei, Mingbo, and Zhi Yi. Qian Wei is a wealthy entrepreneur. Mingbo works at the Liyue Ministry of Civil Affairs, and Zhi Yi is focused on study and travel. Try to keep all that in mind. Of course, it really doesn't matter if you forget, since we'll be assessing them at your high pavilion in a short while. Qian Wei, Mingbo, Zhi Yi. Paimon should be able to remember their names, but what does the assessment involve exactly? Let's leave that until we get to your high pavilion. Alright, heads in the game, people. The stakes don't get much higher than a change in the Zhiqiong. We can't afford to miss anything, no matter how small. Got it, Kaiko. We keep our eyes wide open.
Okay, guess we're going up there. Let me see. Guess you had Yorkshire puddings for the fourth Sunday in a row. Well, that's exciting. wait, what was the other thing? I missed something about mushroom burgers for Paimon. Ooh, I guess you could make mushroom burgers for Paimon. I don't know how to make mushroom burgers. There isn't a recipe for that yet that I have. There might be one in Sumeru. It seems to be the land of mushrooms. She eats slimes? That is true, she does eat slimes. Okay, what else? Okay. Anyway, we're gonna go down here and see what's going on. I don't know what these tests are. How do you test people to be like the Zhiqiong? How does that? I asked Plummets it again. It'll be okay. My legs are getting sore. What is wrong with this assessment officer? This is a huge occasion. I don't even get a chair. I've dealt with all kinds of people in my time, but never have been made to stand while I'm waiting for an appointment. Well, he's getting axed for being rude. I think it's fine. That's called being complacent. If you're happy to just accept the way things are, you'll never be able to change anything in the future. Oh, come on, now you're just being unreasonable. All right, you two, let's not get into a big argument over this. It's not worth it. Qian Wei, that was a bit uncalled for, and Mingbo, cut him some slack. We've all been standing around for a while. It's natural to be getting irritable. Look, how about this? There's no rule saying we're obliged to stand out while we wait, so why don't we borrow some chairs from the guild nearby? Fine, they're not the best quality chairs, to be sure, but under the circumstances, it'd be better than nothing. You went to the assessment venue with Yelan. It looks like all three candidates have arrived. Oh, it was those three? We'll meet them for me soon. Before that, let me run you through the assessment process. I split it into two stages, current affairs and planning, and face-to-face interview. In the first stage, candidates are required to submit a manifesto for Leo's development. In the second stage, we'll ask them some questions in person. Writing a manifesto takes time, so I inform them of this requirement in advance. These are the reports they submitted. Okay, one of those is a lot chunkier than the other two. Wow, one of them is really thick.
It's also worth mentioning a stipulation I gave them. Whoever is appointed as the new Tianshu will be expected to implement their plan as put forward in their manifesto. Failing the occurrence of some cataclysmic event, they will not be permitted to change their plan. Therefore, these two piles of documents in front of us represent where each candidate stands on key policy issues. There's still some time, have a skim through, get a first impression of what each person is proposing. Are you waiting off the side? Just let me know when you're done.
Okay, interesting. What? No, Yao Yao! Yao Yao!
You know what, let's give Yao Yao...
I know this is a bit rubbish, but that's okay, because Yao Yao's gonna stand here for a minute while I read the chat, which means she can heal herself while we're waiting. Let me see. What are you on about? Thanks. Oh! I see what you've done there. You've made a Doctor Who pun, and I like it. And I like it. And I can see where this is coming from. Oh. Anyway, oh hi! Ezumika, welcome to the stream. We are doing the Yelan story quest. And yeah, we're gonna read the manifestos of all these candidates. Yeah, see what they're up to. Or hopefully we will. Clara's first episode. Oh, I see. I thought you were just making a pun, and now I remember she kept trying to make a souffle. Why am I talking to Leanne? Do you need a hand with anything? Huixin is taking some time off at the moment. I'm covering for her. Just let me know if you need anything. But she might be related to the quest then. Who's this lady? Hello. Hello. I was thinking about something. I didn't notice you. Sorry. What's on your mind? I'm thinking about how times can change oh so quickly. Just like how I couldn't return to Leo to see the rite of parting due to the Koku decree. And yet I also happened to witness a turning point in Nazimuth history. Alright, sorry. I forgot to mention this before, but I'm a scholar of history from Leo. My greatest wish is to see history with my own two eyes. It's my belief that in order for us to judge a piece of history, we must first document it completely. My time here in Inazuma has... You're not in Inazuma. Has really got me thinking about how history can be winding and yet changing so very suddenly. Fortunately, I'm no longer some student who needs to worry about her next thesis. Those graduate students who had Inazuma history as their subject are probably in for it now. In the worst case, they might even have spent several sleepless nights rewriting their theses. So what have you heard about the rite of parting? This is probably a very old dialogue because to be honest, I was really terrified when I learned the Rex Lapis is passing a letter from Liyue. Aside from being shocked, I also somehow felt regret I was not in Liyue at such a crucial moment. I didn't even write to my family and my fellow researchers asking them to document what happened at that time. Our Rex Lapis lived through thousands of years, where he's still to see what's happening in Asma, I wonder what he would say. Huh, she's interesting. I don't think I'd met her because she's sort of standing off the side, but maybe I had. Also, Yao Yao. Yao Yao. I'm also using the wrong thing. I was trying to get more seeds because I'm running low on seeds, but I wasn't holding the seed bucket. That's a bit disappointing. Anyway, let me go back over here and do what I was supposed to be doing, which is reading the manifesto. Yelan, do you have anything else to say to me? Finished? Almost. No, we haven't started, but that's fine. Let's read the manifesto. Qianwei's manifesto addresses many commercial issues and provides some very penetrating analysis. The view seems to be that regulations and incentives are both indispensable. Okay. Zhiyi's manifesto covers domestic affairs, foreign affairs, and checks and balances all in great detail. The focus seems to be problem solving. It provides concise and clear solutions to various problems. It's so thick you only have time to skim through it roughly. And Mingbo? Mingbo's manifesto covers domestic affairs quite comprehensively, focusing on people's livelihoods. The core principle seems to be the greater good means a world that works for everyone. Interesting. Finished, huh? What did you think? Everyone took it very seriously. Of course they did. They have the chance to be picked as the new Tianshu, so you can bet they're putting their best foot forwards. And keep in mind, whoever gets in has to execute their plan as written. Nobody wants to have any regrets. What do you think? That's for me to know and you to find out. We can talk more after the interviews. We'll see the candidates now. Let's do one at a time, start with Qianwei. Yes, ma'am. Yan brings Qianwei in. Ah, so you two are the assessment officers, are you? I'd assume that given the great importance of the situation, Lady Ningguang would perhaps be assessing in person. I certainly hadn't imagined I'd be seeing two entirely unfamiliar faces. I trust you've read through my manifesto. I'd be more than happy to clarify any details you found difficult to grasp. It was written with an expert audience in mind, after all. Mind your tone, mister! That was incredibly rude! Relax, it wasn't intended as a personal slight against anyone in particular. I was simply stating a fact. Man, your communication skills, did you learn them from Cloud Retainer? To be fair, that is exactly what happened when we talked to Cloud Retainer. But Cloud Retainer's an adepti crane. She can get away with it. You, my dude, cannot. Can we get rid of him? I don't like him. Clara Taylor, you know this Adeptus? Oh yes, I remember now. You must be the traveler that people are constantly talking about. Yeah, think about that, mister. With your sterling reputation, you must have a respectable level of erudition. Perhaps you'll be able to understand the concepts I put forward, although I shouldn't get my hopes up. After asking Qianwei some questions, Yelan tells him to fetch Mingbo.
Oh, is it my turn? Yes, please introduce yourself.
I'm Mingbo. I work in the Ministry of Civil Affairs. I work there for,
Oh, he's too nervous and... soft. He's getting axed too.
9 years, 5 months, and 3 days. In that time, I've handled 2,347 cases. I have 12 active cases at the moment. They should be concluded in, 16 days.
Or maybe not. These are some very impressive numbers.
My current work is related to urban planning. I'm also responsible for auditing the accounts. To be more precise, there are three parts to the accounts, namely...
Mr. Pinewater, is he not very good at public speaking?
You know what? Let's leave the self-introduction there and move on to some questions.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Yelan pulls away through a few questioning ball and then gets him to fetch Zhiyi.
It's probably gonna be this guy, isn't it? Because he was the mediator earlier. And, I think the other guy, he's not very good at public speaking, but also...
If the guy works in the shadows, does he need to be good at public speaking?
Hello, not gonna lie, I'm feeling a little nervous.
What would you like to know? You're here to assess me, so ask away and I'll answer your questions to the best of my ability. The manifesto is very wide in its scope, but you don't seem to be personally involved in many of the specific fields. How can you be sure you have the ability to put your plan into action?
That was blunt.
Very fair question, I completely understand where you're coming from.
Is this his one?
But I am confident in my plan. I visited many different places, talked to lots of people with far more expertise than myself, and my manifesto is a conclusion of these efforts. Of course, two different problems can be interconnected in very complicated ways, and you might reach two very contradictory conclusions depending on which one you're focusing on. What I've tried to do is strike a balance. In other words, represent an optimal solution to all the problems as a whole. How do you plan to determine whether you're right or wrong about your proposed solution being the optimal one?
A great question. Well, I start by having my colleagues and the secretaries at the UI Pavilion evaluate any proposals before implementation. Post-implementation, it would all come down to the results. If it turned out my judgment was to blame for poor results, I would take responsibility.
Nice answer. Alright, next question. After asking Zhiyi a few questions, Yelan sends him on his way. He's like a great guy, everything he said was thoughtful and logical, and he was just a pleasure to listen to.
See, I want to agree, but the fact that they're, like, saying it like this makes me think there's, like, a but. And I don't know what the but is gonna be.
I agree. Here's my take on what we just learned. As you saw, Qian Wei is highly knowledgeable. He proposes many excellent ideas in the manifesto which effectively target the big issues. But he's very proud and incredibly stubborn. He doesn't care much about other people's feelings. Mingguo's plan is more thorough and more measured. You can tell he's meticulous in his work, very detail-oriented. Zhiqiong and Qian Wei are otherwise polar opposites. Mingguo is not very articulate and comes across as very timid in conversation.
Perfect summary. Paimon couldn't agree more. You're good at this, Yelan.
Last but not least, Zhiyi. His manifesto is full of present details. His methodology is sound. His proposals cover a broad range of fields, which is quite a rare feat. The depth he goes into in each and every area means it can only be a product of painstaking work. Plus, he is modest and good at dealing with people. But what really interests me is that many of his views happen to coincide with Uncle Tian's. Having someone like Zhiyi take the position would certainly put Uncle Tian's mind at rest.
Great. We'll see. Let's go back and report to Uncle Tian.
Okay, yeah, this dude's getting the job? I think so. Unless there's a big butt somewhere.
I think so too.
Oh.
Oh no. The roulette.
Oh, I didn't say meh.
Too late, I thought he was good too. Is the answer teamwork?
Possibly, because it seemed to be that all of his staff was like a team operation to figure out what was the best solution. So maybe the answer is teamwork.
Well, so I do see the roulette, so I guess I'll just pause the next sufficiently long looking line
and we'll see how it goes.
I consider it sufficiently long if it takes two lines on the screen.
Oh, everyone gets the job?
I don't think so. I think it's more that it's going to be this guy because he seems to be more of like a mediator. Because I don't think, I mean, the other people can probably be quite prominent, but you can probably only have one, like, president.
You tell Uncle Tian about the assassin process.
I see, then it's more or less as I anticipated.
Alright, then let me ask this. The ideas in Zhiyi's manifesto are very similar to your own. Is there any particular reason behind this?
I didn't want to say anything when I gave you the list of candidates for fear of affecting your judgment, but I can tell you now. Those three candidates have all studied under me in the past. It's only natural that they share some similarities with me. But Qian Wei went on to focus on his business, and Mingbo has always been occupied with his work in the Ministry of Civil Affairs. Of all of them, Zhiyi was with me for the longest duration.
Wait, so how did you get to know them all, Uncle Qian?
Is that a good enough line? I should have used the other one, but I didn't. Is that a good enough line? Maybe?
Friendship is cool with power of friendship. What was the animosity? Meh? What do you mean, meh? I guess you just don't like the line, but... But still, it's a long line!
Anyway, yes, I guess friendship, by definition, animosity has got to be killed by the power of friendship. It's just how it works. Oh, hello, Brick Street Kid. Welcome to the stream. I love a good potato. Anyway, I eagerly anticipate this voice note, even though I know it's not gonna be the best one, but like, that's the beauty of the thing, isn't it? You just get a random line. You don't get to pick the line. I already forgot who all these people are, as in I see these things and they're talking about the names, but I forgot which person was linked to which name. I think Qian Wei was the arrogant guy, Mingbo was the soft guy, and Ji Yi was the all-rounder. Okay, I received my voice note. Oh gosh. Do I want to know what accent you've given me? Probably not. I've listened to the voice note. I don't know how to describe this. Oh, you can hear it. Oh lol, I didn't mute it, but I didn't know it was loud enough to hear. Whoops. Could you hear it clearly or just a little bit? Oh, I don't think I can make that voice. A little bit. Oh dear. Let me listen again. I'll mute it this time. I was hoping it was sufficiently close to my ear that it wouldn't transfer, but apparently not.
To me by an old friend. Mingbo came to my attention in the course of my work. As for Ji, that was pure happenstance.
That was my best attempt. I don't even know what that voice was supposed to be. It was giving me like Professor Snape vibes, but like from Harry Potter Puppet Pals or something. Oh, but I don't think I could get the, like, it sits in a certain way, like you need to be like rounder or something, and I couldn't get it.
Oh dear.
We first met while fishing. Gradually, as we got to know each other, we started discussing all sorts of topics. Ji came from a poor family, his parents died when he was very young, but he was a gifted student and a fast learner. Reminded me of a younger version of myself, so I started out giving him a few words of advice when we were out fishing and noticed how quickly he caught on. Sounds like he's a friend to you, sounds like he's family to you. Quite, and now all of a sudden he's growing to a mature young man. It's a joy to see, but it also gets one thinking. The young are growing up and I am growing old, how time flies, no one can escape the cycle of life. I don't know, Uncle Qian, you seem in a pretty good shape to me. You might have another few years of work left in you, don't you think? Oh, you. There's really no need to console me. Having less energy than I used to isn't such a bad thing. It just means I finally have a good reason to retire and spend my days doing what old men like me should be doing. Going fishing whenever I feel like it. I love it. He has such high ambitions. Sounds like you sure love fishing, Uncle Qian. There's nothing quite like fishing to pass the time. A freshly caught fish. Ah, they make the most beautiful fish soup with barely any preparation required. Fresh fish soup? Mmm, sounds tasty. Doesn't it? Also, some time ago, Juyi purchased a very special recipe from an old fisherman. When we've been fishing recently, Juyi always brings some extra ingredients he prepared in advance. The addition of these makes the soup taste even more wonderful. That flavour makes for a fond memory, but at my age, who knows how many more chances I have left to taste it again. Very many chances, I'm sure. Oh, can Paimon come next time too? Paimon really wants to try it. Let's get back to the matter at hand. Uncle Chen, we've reported back. Do you have a verdict? I appointed you as the assessment officer and I trust your judgment. Had you not asked me why Juyi's ideas were so similar to mine, I was not going to mention my history with any of them. The decision must be guided by what is fair and right. Please disregard all other considerations and make your final decision only after a thorough review of each candidate's talents and capabilities. Remember, you must be thorough. Understood. Okay, good, let's go talk somewhere else. Bye-bye, Uncle Tian. Look after yourself. You follow Yelan outside the tea house. So it's going to be Juyi, right? The manifesto is written well and he's the best speaker. Easy, let's not rush. There's no time limit for this assessment. Huh? So are you going to give them more tests or something? Nothing like that. The assessment itself is complete, but let me give you a word of advice. Things are not always as they appear. The biggest no-no in intelligence work is to only get information from the person of interest themselves. The truth is almost always hidden beneath many layers of deception. You have to get information through many different channels. For example, Wenyin Shanghua. Yes? Oh. Where did these guys come from? Lady Yelan, what are your orders? Ah, who are they? Where did they come from? Did they scare you? These two are Wen Yin and Shang Hua. They work for me. As my trusted assistants, they are always standing guard nearby. They also perform various assignments as required. Shang Hua is a business expert who gets his information by trading. Wen Yin relies on word of mouth, and there is also Wu Pei, who's not here right now. That meathead must have been out there on sea surveillance for some time now. Is he alright? I seem to remember that he can't swim. I think I'd take that guy down, sending out a little wind and waves. Shang Hua, visit all the commerce guilds and look into Qian Wei's background. Wen Yin, go to the Ministry of Civil Affairs and look through Mingbo's work files. Yes, ma'am. So what about Juyi? Juyi will obviously, as the most promising candidate, we will be investigating him ourselves. Look into the docks first, lots of people passing through there, you can find out all kinds of things. If we're looking for information, why don't we try talking to Bo Lai, the owner of Manuel Boutique? He does business at the North Wharf. Maybe he'll have some news for us. That's actually not a bad idea, let's go and ask him. Anyway, I guess we're gonna go talk to... Oh, no, I thought we were talking to... I thought we were talking to the Jade guy, but I think we're talking to, like, the suspicious smuggler guy. let's go and talk to him. Where'd he go? Ooh, what's Bo Lai doing here today? Ooh, there's a person! Look, you're asking prices, that is just too high. I can't buy it at this price. How am I supposed to turn a profit? Come on, hear me out. I'm telling you, this is the single best batch of Sunsetti as ever. You won't find anyone who disputes that. I accidentally dropped one into a well, and even the water turned sweet. Even so. Shh, alright, I'll let you in on a little secret. The boss of Second Life also wants to buy from me, but I haven't responded yet. Oh, this guy's a haggler. If you won't take them, I'll just have to partner with them instead, and neither of us wants that. Okay, well, when you put it that way, I'll accept your asking price. I'll take all your stock, trying to sell a single one to Second Life. Trading with who was negotiating with Bo Lai leaves. Oh, what are you doing here? And to be clear, these Sunsetias are mine. I got to them first. Don't get any ideas. Knock yourselves out. I've got more than enough in my bag. I actually want to ask you about a guy called Juyi. Have you heard of him before? Juyi? Yes, he's quite well known. I've heard a story about him. They say he was born into poverty, his parents died when he was young, and he was treated cruelly by the local community. One of his neighbors was terribly rude to him all the time, but Juyi never retaliated, and when his neighbor went bankrupt, he even helped support the family. He returned cruelty with kindness, injustice with peace offerings, a gentleman of talent and character, and, oh, how did I not notice him sooner? In fact, maybe I'm not too late. If I could hire him to be the brand ambassador for Manuel Boutique, he sounds like a decent man. We could finally breathe a sigh of relief. Why are you asking about him anyway? You aren't looking for a brand ambassador too, are you? Well then, in that case, the higher bidder takes the... that's Juyi right over there. Why don't we go and talk to him? Where? It's him, alright. Looks like he's chatting with Lin Na. Kaiko, come on, let's follow them and listen in. Try to let him see you. We want this information to be as truthful as possible. That sounds like a sneak behind them and don't get seen quest thing right now. I'm so bad at those. I'll just go and fetch an employment contract. Hey, don't try and cut me out of this. Hey! Understand, let's walk and talk. Oh gosh, you've already failed. You're looking to buy a wineware set? Now I see you're a connoisseur, so I won't bother trying to con you. I trust you understand our shop quite well. Oh no, he's...
Oh no.
Truth is, an old friend of mine... No! I'm behind the thing!
You have serious doubts about your tailing skills. To be fair, Yelan, I also have serious doubts about my tailing skills.
Oh dear. Let's see. Oh, but like you fell for it, but there wasn't even offer from Second Life. Always. Of course, I can't believe you fell for it.
You'd think he'd be better at this sort of thing, but I thought he was a smart, sort of sneaky man, but I think he's just a bit
dumb sometimes.
Stealth check, Kaiko always rolls nat one of those though.
Yeah.
We're gonna try this again. I have faith. Okay. Okay, where's he going?
Hide behind the barrel.
No, he can already see me. No, he can't. It's all good. Okay.
This is where he saw me last time. The truth is, an old friend of mine who likes to have a drink now and then. He fancies himself as a man of culture, but doesn't care for anything extravagant, so I thought I might buy him a set of high-quality fakes. How very thoughtful of you. Leave it to me then. Come and collect it at Zhiqiong Art Antiques whenever it's convenient. Thank you very much, Miss Linlong. It's my pleasure, Mr. G. These days it's quite rare for someone of your standing to still keep up with their old friends. It's nice to see. I'll be sure to pick out a good set for you. You can count on me.
Oh! we walked far enough away you didn't see me. It's all good. Okay! It only took two tries!
G seems to get along really well with everyone. Are you satisfied now, Yelan? Seems like everyone that G... thinks that Juyi's a great guy. We shouldn't jump to conclusions just yet. Let's go check out the wharf where he usually goes fishing. Do we have to? Wait, you're not just gonna try to dig up some dirt on Juyi because you want to be Tianshu yourself, are you? Maybe I am, maybe I'm not, but hey, if I do become Tianshu, I'll look out for you guys. You'll be able to try all the finest food for free. How does that sound? We will? Well, come on, off to the south wharf we go.
Paimon, that's not how you make government this is bribery! Oh dear, Paimon. This is how corruption starts. Oh dear.
Wait, who's Little Potato? Little Potato? Told me before.
I'm sure you did, doesn't mean I remember.
Who's Potato?
I'm so confused. Oh dear.
The wharf is as busy as ever. I hear the anglers here sometimes sell their fish to the nearby fishmongers. Let's see what Uncle Sun has to say. The Superior Patat.
Wait, the Superior Patat is Little Potato? Why is that Little Potato?
I thought it was just potato.
So confused.
Welcome, what would you like to buy today? We're here to ask you about someone. We're here to buy some information. Sorry to interrupt, we're actually members of the Liyue Anglers Association, and we just wanted to ask a few questions about someone. We've heard about this young man called Ji, who's supposed to be a fantastic fisherman. Just wondered if you happen to have heard of him. Yelan made up a whole fake identity without even batting an eyelid. That's because she's an international super spy.
Super spy.
Yes, Ji's been making quite a name for himself recently. I've got some friends who travel all over the place, and they all tell me if somewhere they go to meet. Tell me everywhere they go, they meet someone who's heard of him. Apparently, he had a rather tough time growing up. Had to work several jobs alongside his studies to make ends meet. How does that saying go? What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Well, if there's anything to that logic, he's sure to be phenomenally successful one day. Yeah, we think so too. But I'm afraid your Anglers Association might be in for disappointment. Oh, why is that? He's good at a lot of things, but fishing isn't one of them. He fishes at the wharf and then sells what he catches to me on occasion. His catches are always mediocre, not terrible, but equally nothing to write home about. If you're looking to recruit some new members though, I do know a few top anglers I could put you in touch with. Sounds fantastic. I've got a couple of other things to attend to right now. So why don't I come back some other time and we can chat over a drink? Sure thing, see you. Everywhere they go, they meet someone who's heard of him. Come on, let's keep asking around. I have a feeling this man has planted information everywhere. You know, like he's made himself look good. Like, I don't think he's actually a fan of fishing. He probably started fishing to meet Uncle Tian. Which actually, how did he know Uncle Tian was Uncle Tian? Let me see. Hello, the Superior Protector. Chanapis, what have you done? You summoned them. You summoned her. Oh. I see. I've seen the reference now to the little little potato. I like it. Anyway, hello, Superior Protector. Good to see you. Anyway, Oh! Nicholson, hello, welcome to the stream. We are doing the Yelan quest. Okay, I'm suspicious of this guy now. But like, I don't think he's inherently suspicious, but he probably is a little bit. Just a little bit. Here to buy some fish, is 300 for one or 3 for 1,000. You better hurry up. Hurry, when they're gone, they're gone. The math doesn't math with this guy. The math doesn't math. But I have paid him 1,000 for 3 because I just really needed fish. And everywhere else was sold out. You better hurry when they're gone, they're gone. Hello, we're from the Society for Fish Price Research. We'd just like to ask a few questions. Oh wow, she switched identity again. Society for Fish Price Research, I haven't done anything illegal, stay out of my business. Please don't worry, we're just here to conduct a simple survey. We've heard about a certain GE who's been selling fresh fish at low prices in this area recently. Do you know anything about this? This isn't about me. You should have said something you know. I know the guy, I can tell you what I know. I haven't heard anything about him selling fresh fish at low prices, but it wouldn't surprise me if it was him. Oh, why is that? Because he's so poor, his parents died when he was very young, and his alcoholic father still owed a huge amount of debt. No one wanted to have anything to do with him. He was still a kid when he first came to the wharf. His clothes are ragged, and he had a bandage wrapped around his head. He managed to survive thanks to Uncle Tian, who gave him some food, but still to this day, he doesn't have a lot of mora to his name. I mean, he can afford to eat and everything, but you often see him haggling with others over just a few mora. They wouldn't be surprised to find out he's been selling a few fish. It's not like he catches much anyway, so it's not going to affect my business. Oh, don't tell him I said that. You'd rather he didn't know. Well, I spoke to him once briefly, and I just had a feeling he really cares what other people think of him. I think he's pretty low self-esteem, but hey, it's hardly my place to say anything. What he's achieved already puts most people to shame. And he's perfect, I just wouldn't want to upset him, that's all. I see, well thank you for sharing that with us. Not a problem, and just for the record, there's absolutely nothing wrong with the price of my fish. The more times you say it, the less convincing it becomes. Doesn't have a lot of mora to his name, okay, let's keep going. To be fair, Zhongli doesn't have any mora to his name either, so maybe... that's not a problem. Ready to say? Man Qiming, the time I shouldn't... I'd like for you to read my fortune on the matter of my love life. Love life, again, this must be the 10th time this month. I only keep coming because your predictions are so accurate, especially that one thing you keep telling me, being preoccupied with the outcome of the divination is not conducive to finding true love. That's why from now on my focus will be solely on the divination itself, not the outcome. I see, well let me try to explain this differently. The true love may be impossibly far away, or it may be right under your nose. You cannot force it, but when this day comes, it will reveal itself to you right before your eyes. Who knows, maybe today will be that day. Ah, I understand it now. Pray tell what you pursue me. Please tell what you presume to have understood. If you do feel the same way from this day forth, I will live solely to bring you happiness before you marry. No, thank you. Well, are you free tonight? No, and now I'm calling the guards. This was unrelated to the quest, but I'm quite glad I stumbled across that. That's quite funny. This guy, I think he's the guy who does the commissions about his love life. Oh, what a dramatic dude. Oh. What happened? Did somebody, did little Patrick ask how many potatoes is too many potatoes? And then want to find out, and then... That was 30. Oh, hello, Termite. Good to see you. This is honestly a very funny moment to arrive in. I guess censorship has gone too far. Apparently 30 potatoes is too far. I love it. I love it so much. But also, what a tragedy. Anyway, hey, it's you guys. Wait, what's this phrase? Oh, yeah, honored to meet you. What brings you to me? The truth is, we are but newcomers to this territory. We hear tell of a great martial artist, Master Dooku, who knows everything there is to know. Hence, we sought you out to seek for your guidance. Really? People said, I know everything there is to know. But of course, we also heard that Master Dooku is kind and virtuous, swordsman who never turns away anyone who comes with questions. Great, so what do you wish to know? Nothing happens on this street that I don't know about. Now she's lying to a kid. But it seems to have made his day, I guess it's a white lie. So Master Dooku, have you heard of one by the name of Ji? Sure have, you mean that guy that all the grown-ups are talking about these days? I've heard many tales of Ji. For example, I can't remember. Probably because it's nothing that important. I prefer stories about sword-fighting heroes. Oh, I can completely understand that. Then let me ask you this. Do you remember roughly when the grown-ups started talking about Ji? Oh yeah, I know that. It was about 2 or 3 months ago. Before that, people always used to talk about Ji in a kind of nasty tone of voice, but 2 or 3 months ago, suddenly everyone started to like him. Sometimes he gives me candy, so I'm glad that people are starting to like him now. Just as I thought. Huh? What do you mean? I mean, just as I thought, Master Dooku is indeed as kind and virtuous as the legends claim. I'm not that great. Oh yeah, one more other thing. These days, there's a lot of people I've never seen before talking about Ji's stories in the street. They seem like nice people. Oh, definitely. Great, so next time I see them, I'll say hi, and I guess I can share some of my candies with them too. Certainly, you can also tell my friend in Yangshan Tea House about what they're up to. I'm sure my friend would also like to say hi to them. Thank you, ma'am. You're welcome. Well then, fare thee well, Master Dooku. Until we meet again. Oh no. Any of that sounds strange to you? Yeah, a little bit. Strange, what was strange about it? Ji seems to have a great reputation. Uncle Sam and Uncle Gao spoke so highly of him, and Dooku Sho seems to like him too. True, but the issue is, where did his sudden celebrity come from? It almost seems too good to be true. Sudden, too good to be true? What do you mean? He returns cruelty with kindness and had to work to support his studies. These are the kinds of things that make someone well known in their hometown. But Uncle Sun said even his friends who travel far and wide hear about him wherever they go. There's a little bit of top if you ask me. Do you remember what Dooku Sho said about Ji's stories? Clearly they left him with a good impression of the guy, but beyond that, he wasn't interested in the details. That's a reaction I would expect from any normal person. Plus, there's the fact that all this praise of Ji has only been happening within the last 2 or 3 months. His childhood, his studies, a thing with his neighbors, none of these are recent events, and why are these stories only going around now? You feel like that, it is kind of strange. Of course, if that's all there was to it, I wouldn't look into it any further. Ji was born into a poor family, paying people to get his stories out there is within the rules of the game as far as I'm concerned. The problem is, do you remember what Uncle Gao said about him? He's stayed poor his whole life, everything he's earned, he's either spent on studying, traveling, or paying off debts. I don't think he has the moral to pay for a publicity campaign. Oh, someone's helping him. Maybe he's working with someone. Right, and that changes everything. It would mean a powerful faction is trying to gain influence over the Liu Qixing. That's the worst case scenario, but all too often the most pessimistic speculation turns out to be the closest to the truth. Someone's trying to gain influence over the Qixing? That sounds serious. What should we do? Even if we asked Ji about it, surely there's no way he'd admit it. First, we need to find out who's supporting him. Don't worry, I've got a plan. Remember the current affairs and planning stage of the assessment? Since the successful candidate is duty-bound to implement their plan after taking office, the manifesto tells us their stance on key issues. Whoever is secretly helping Ji must be seeking to benefit from his actions after his appointment, so we should be able to find some hints in Ji's manifesto on who we're dealing with. Come on, let's get back to Yangsheng Tea House. Thanks for watching, everyone. If you've enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe. If you'd like to see me play live, then check out my Twitch channel. You can find me on Wednesdays and Sundays at 8 p.m. GMT. Thanks again, and have a great day!